I'm a big fan of color, as you can pretty much tell. So what I like to do is like to try to find an interesting way to bring my darks and my lights to go through. Nighttime scene, kind of, you know, but it's more kind of like Mad Max Beyond the Thunder. It's got kind of like a battle scene going on between like the characters and bring them together. Basically, to me, it's kind of like a battle piece, you know? Very looking like Egyptian, you know, scroll, things like that. They have the different kinds of items that I always use, like, really use just to put the door in and things. I'm trying to bring that in.
Forgive me here. I'm pulled in by your color and your technique and the design, but I never asked you your name.
I'm Mia Simone.
Mia Simone, nice to meet you. Now, did you sketch this out ahead of time? You are just, what we see right now is the evolution of this piece of art.
Yep, just let it rip. Actually, one of the vendors here, Antonio, who runs the barbershop, called me and he was like, we did that 2 days ago. I was like, hey, you're doing an event down here at the bazaar. You want to come paint? I'm like, sounds good. Yep, sure. So, here I am. It's actually been a really long day. I was supposed to be here at 3. My grandmother, she was in the hospital for 2 days, so I'm like, I didn't get here until 5. I'm just glad I finally got here.
It will stay here as a permanent installation.
Yeah.
Awesome. So here we see something being immortalized in this moment, and it's being captured on film.
Yes.
So glad that you could document. Industrial Center Bazaar, they might meet you and see some of your artwork.
Might run into Mia Simone again, yes. And I design clothing, I make jewelry, so this is just really like branching out a little bit extra.
So you don't usually do this type of artwork?
Not this big, definitely. But no, I just really got back into it. I needed to kind of find a way to mix it.
Any more to share about some of the artwork?
Oh, I want to ask you about the tiger.
Okay, the tiger. And those are significant parts of the collection.
painting, like watercolor.
So now, what is your favorite? Photography?
Well, yeah, because I'm not painting. You know, if I could paint, But at the same time, I like simplifying. And that, you know, if a lot of my stuff, if you look at it, just the eye, just the light, you know, a lot of that is, that's the point of just catching one little aspect.
You know, that statement right there, what that reminded me of was the Statue of David. Have you ever seen it in real life?
No, I haven't.
Have you heard the story about David? Like what the sculptor did?
No.
Like
no.
That has to do with the eyes. When you see the signature look of David, it shows his strength in the story of David, you know, being small and mighty.
Yeah, well, I know David's story, David.
And the sculpture captures that perfectly. But then if you walk around David and really look him in the eye, you can see it. And so when I drew that sculpture, when I saw it up close and personal, that's what I drew. Because the eyes are more meaningful than showing the strength, the signature look that you get from those people. But I was there, so I did that.
Sure.
And so there's more complexity involved. And so I appreciate it, but that's my interpretation of my experience.
Sure.
So, we're doing this other documentary.
Yeah.